We're combing through the aisles of Vulcan Video, an independent video store here in Austin, Texas, to find the most obscure, the strangest, and the overlooked gems of yesterday. This is the Vulcan Vault. Welcome to the Vulcan Vault. We got a great one today with Brian. Brian, what'd you pick out for us?
I picked Skin Deep, the late 80s Blake Edwards joint, and it really is my favorite Blake Edwards film.
Now, why is it your favorite Blake Edwards film?
Blake Edwards is definitely one of my favorite comedic filmmakers. Like, he mastered slapstick better than most people. Like, he is just the best. Like, the Pink Panther movies are so good. The Party's good. But I'm more of a fan of his kind of 80s, like his later stuff, because like with most filmmakers that started pre-70s and then got into that era, they were able to do more things that they weren't able to do. So these movies now have nudity in them and swearing and things you couldn't do in the Pink Panther movies. Maybe he wanted to do that but couldn't. And so like 10 and Blind Date are just like really good, just R-rated like adult comedies, and this is definitely like the best of those.
You still want to kill him, do me a favor and take him outside. Those are new sheets.
Go ahead and shoot.
It stars John Ritter, who I feel is like a deeply, deeply underrated physical comedian. Like, if you watch Three's Company, which is hands down my favorite television program like of all time, like, he is really good at doing pratfalls, at just doing double takes, at doing just, like, any kind of physical comedy. Like, as good as I feel the best people. Like, and I'm not joking. Like, I really think, like, him is, like, he is as good as, like, a Harpo or a Charlie Chaplin or a Buster Keaton. Like, no lying. Like, I really feel that. Like, fight me if you disagree. John Ritter. And in this movie, I feel, like, really shows off his talents more than any other film. Because the movie's plot is kind of set up just to do jokes. Like, it's a very thin plot where basically he's this sort of drunk, sort of womanizing writer, like, at his, you know, like, wit's end, and he just doesn't know what to do with himself. So it's him kind of trying to date women in all these, like, horrible failed scenarios where it's just an excuse for him to do this amazing physical comedy. There's this great part where he, like, his body's in pain and he can't stop twitching. And it's like this long shot of him just walking and his body just moving and gyrating, and it's incredible. And there's very amazing, and like, I don't know how they did it, but like, there's this part where he's standing in a doorway, and there's supposed to be a tidal wave that just kind of splashes through this door. So clearly they had like a huge water tank, and it's really John Ritter just getting hit with this huge amount of water and just flying across the room, and it's so awesome. Like, you only see Jackie Chan do stuff like that, but it's John Ritter doing it, which is amazing. And then there's, like, because it's the 80s, there's, like, him trying to do aerobics, which, you know, like, he's like, you can't do aerobics, John Ritter, what are you doing? And there's a part where he's, like, kind of trying to get intimate with, like, a bodybuilding, like, 80s, like, huge, like, kind of, like, gorgeous ladies, a wrestling-looking lady.
How do you feel about that?
Like Mrs. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
And the best part, of course, and the part that made this movie famous at this time, and people have since forgotten about, is that there's this long scene where, with the glow-in-the-dark condoms, and it's basically, it's kind of like that scene in Pee-wee's Big Adventure where it's just all black and you see the eyeballs, but instead of eyeballs, it's just like these glowing erect penises. It's John Ritter's erect penis is kind of floating around, and then some other guy enters the room with his glow-in-the-dark condom on, and they have a duel, so you just kind of see these two. It looks like Pong, like, it's, but with dong. It's called dong. And it's just these two penises just doing this thing, and it's amazing. It's just, and it goes on forever, and it's just like, you couldn't, Blake Edwards wouldn't be able to do that gag in 1964, but maybe he thought of it then and then, like, stored it for when the 80s let people just get away with anything in a movie.
See, and I'm not even sure you could do that now, like, in a mainstream movie.
Oh, what? Like the movies that try to be crazy, like a super bad, like, they didn't have glow-in-the-dark condom scenes in it. Like, take that. But also, you have Vincent Gardenia in the movie, who, of course, like, great actor from, like, Moonstruck and Little Shop of Horrors, and he plays kind of his John Ritter's only friend in this movie. He plays the bartender who kind of gives him, you know, advice about women and things.
I'm a bartender, not just a psychiatrist.
And then, because it's a Blake Edwards film, of course, there's a Henry Mancini soundtrack.
Get me the fuck out of here.
But it's like late 80s Henry Mancini, so it's not the memorable sort of like Peter Gunn, Pink Panther Henry Mancini. It's more kind of like smooth, kind of jazz. Like, it's the equivalent of like when your parents took you to like a seafood restaurant when you were a child, and like the band or the music that would be playing on the radio. Like, it's kind of very dentist office-y, not to diss Henry Mancini, but like his later stuff not as strong. You know, but I can't write music, so who am I to say? but yeah, this movie is really, really, really funny. Like, one of the top five slapstick comedies in my book. Yeah.
That is some high praise for Skin Deep, Blake Edwards, John Ritter. Brian, got another good one this week, man. Nice job.
Thank you.
For more news and reviews, keep checking in with AintItCool.com.